Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my brand new playlist, which is going to talk about the serverless framework. In my earlier playlist, I talked about AWS components like API Gateway, Lambda, DynamoDB, SQS, SNS. That was like manually going through the Lambda code and doing all the changes. Now we are talking about automating the deployment of Lambda, testing the Lambda code offline. All these things we can do with the help of serverless framework. It's like an independent framework, nothing to do with any cloud. But yes, serverless we are going to use with particular cloud vendor. Like here we are going to talk about serverless with AWS, right? So why we need serverless? All these questions we will start exploring, right? So serverless is a framework which can work with any cloud vendor. We will be targeting AWS. Earlier we did how we were creating Lambda is like uploading the zip file or manually going and writing the code and then deploying it. But all that is going to be automated. Even you don't need to create API gateway, any cloud formation resources. Everything will be done by the serverless framework. What you need to do is write the configuration and tell your Lambda, tell your serverless configuration that, okay, this is the handler and this is the endpoint and these are the events I'm going to create. Okay, so this course is divided into the multiple sections. First, we will talk about why we need the serverless framework in our stack, why we should learn it if we are writing the serverless applications, first of all. Second thing is, we'll talk about serverless CLI, what all different options are there, how to create a serverless viable configurations to deploy your basic Lambda, and what all things you can put in the serverless.yml configuration, the resource, the handlers, right? All the AWS configuration, like in which particular region you are deploying your Lambda, what is your AWS profile and all these things. And then we'll talk about Lambda which with real world examples, like Lambda talking to SQS, SNS, and Lambda triggers. Like there is a Lambda which gets triggered when you do a file upload or when you do a message post onto SQS. Okay, then we will do some real world applications, maybe a simple REST application, REST APIs for your backend, because Lambdas are nothing but function as a service. So we'll be writing these functions and exposing the REST API. Then most important thing is testing these Lambdas offline. So there is a serverless offline plugins. We are going to talk about testing it offline and then integrating the whole thing with the CI/CD pipeline. So we don't need to do any manual thing. We just focus on writing the Lambda function on my local system. When I do just SLS deploy, everything is getting taken care either through the pipeline or either through my commit and my PRs. Okay, so let's get started on that.